What a variety. If I thought about all these devotionals and how many years they span and how different they are, it's amazing to me how God uses them in my life, you know, to speak to me, but also to instruct me and to guide me. And, you know, it's a wonder, the scriptures themselves, but that's not so miraculous to me as God himself. I mean, to be honest, because he inspired, you know, the writers of the scriptures to put forth his word, you know, and he allowed them their personality and their particular styles in it, and yet still coordinated all of it to work in a perfect picture that is like a tapestry that he laid out and is able to communicate to us throughout time a perfect example and message that we would be able to relate to ourselves and use as a communication tool to speak with God and to direct our attention to him. And you know, I see that happening in everything, you know, in life, if we just turn our attention back to God. And if we ask Jesus to direct us as he would go, and then we find that all the circumstances of our life begin to make sense. They fit as pieces of the puzzle into the picture of the life that we are. In my time of sojourning on this earth, I see my studies as well as my ministry and as well as my evotionals and devotionals all coordinated together to change the inner me and help guide the outer me to a place of knowing who he is in a more intimate way than I've ever known before. I hope that's working for you too, because time is running out, and we need to seek the Lord while he may be found and listen to what he would say to us. In Streams in the Desert, neither know we what to do, but our eyes are upon you. A life was lost in Israel because a pair of human hands were laid unbidden upon the Ark of God. They were placed upon it with the best intent to steady it when trembling and shaking as the oxen drew it along the rough way. But they touched God's work presumptuously, and they fell paralyzed and lifeless. Much of the life of faith consists in letting things alone. If we wholly trust and interest to God, we must keep our hands off of it, and he will guard it for us better than we can help him. Rest in the Lord and wait patiently for him. Fret not thyself because of him who prospereth in his way, because of the man who brings wicked devices to pass. You know, it's amazing to me is that I have seen in my life, in certain jobs that I've worked in where I laid it out before God sometimes, and I worked my tail end off and busted my back, so to speak, you know, for someone in a job setting, and was sometimes abused and sometimes taken advantage of, and I never defended myself. You know, I always took it back to God and, you know, let it go, because at the time God spoke to me and said, just don't worry about it. And the amazing thing is that, you know, I can say for myself that it's impossible to explain this, but I know, like, one business that I had worked for as a manager in Alaska. All I could do is say, okay, I was in Alaska in a remote area, and this business really took advantage of me, and I didn't defend myself. And down the road, I was sitting, must have been 5 years later, reading in a newspaper on maybe, and I rarely read newspapers, I practically never read newspapers, but for some reason I found a newspaper, I guess, and picked it up, and I was like on the fifth page in, and there was a little tiny article, and it described the business that I had worked at had burned down completely. And I was amazed. I thought, that's interesting. And the Lord spoke to me in that moment and said, you know, he does bring back unto those that abuse and use and destroy you or whatever may be, that he'll bring back judgment upon the heads of those that do despitefully use you. So don't be so worried about sometimes your own circumstances and situation when someone else is taking advantage of you, because let God be your guide, and he will not only provide, but he'll take care of it. And I wish I could say that was only one isolated occasion, but I've been in a lot of situations where I keep track, you know, and I wait on God to see what he would do about the circumstance and situation. And sadly, every time that I have not defended myself, I have seen the results on others. And that isn't a pleasant place for them, you know. And I even now think that it's easier to say, God forgive them and God have mercy on them, than to let God do as he would do, you know, when he's defending his children. So don't be surprised if you see that happen sometime in your life, when you look back and you can count off those places where you were, you could say, quote unquote, in the right, and yet you were abused. God can see, and God does intervene, and he does reward according to the principle that we call reaping and sowing. If you sow to the flesh, you'll reap of the flesh, you will, and so will other people. But if you sow to the Spirit, you'll reap of the Spirit. Likewise, if you abuse someone, you'll receive the judgment of it. And so too, if someone abuses you, they'll receive judgment in this life as well as the life to come. Things may seem to be going all wrong, but he knows as well as we, and he will arise in the right moment if we are really trusting him so fully as to let him work in his own way and time. There is nothing so masterly as inactivity in some things, and there is nothing so hurtful as restlessness working, for God has undertaken to work his sovereign will. Being a hamster in a cage to me seems like the most worthless, meaningless, purposeless job you could possibly have. And if you find yourself always running in a circle, and it seems like you've got more and more and more and more and more to do, and God has never told you to be still, I would be suggesting to you that you might want to reconsider what it is you're doing and ask God to lead. Because when God leads, he also gives a time of rest, a time of peace, a time of trust, a time to wait on the Lord. And if you haven't had any of those waiting times, you might be doing something without God rather than with him. And you'll know when you're with him because you'll see it accomplished. That's simple. So if God tells you to wait, just wait. He will bring it to pass.